Hello, my name is Dr. Marwa Sawi. I'm graduated from the Department of Chemistry and Biochemistry, Faculty of Science, Zagazig University, with total grade excellent with honors in 2010. And I obtained a general diploma in 2012. And then I obtained a master degree in biochemistry in 2017. And then I obtained a doctoral degree in biochemistry in 2021 with total grade excellent with honors. And I had three international publications linked with biochemistry and pharmacy and medicine. Now we will talk about basics of chemistry, session 2 for third secondary. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe my channel to reach to a large number of students to learn more and more about chemistry. Now, we will talk about acids. How to write the chemical formula of inorganic compounds. Sulfuric acid. We know in the previous session that there are two splits. The first split always positive split, and write it on the left, then add the right, we write the second split is the negative split. So any compound consists of positive split and negative split. The positive split, write it on the left. When we talk about acids, acid means that it contains single proton, H positive, or double proton, 2H positive, or 3H positive, or 3 protons. When we talk about acid, we must write H positive on the left as the positive split. Then we write the negative split here, sulfuric. So sulfate group SO4 negative 2. Then the second step, that exchange valences. So SO4 negative 2, this valency negative 2, right here 2, and here positive 1, so write 1 under the sulfate group. So we now can write the chemical formula of the sulfuric acid, H2SO4. So the sulfuric acid chemical formula is H2SO4. Another acid, carbonic acid. Carbonic acid means that acid, we must write H positive on the left. Then we write the another group or the negative group on the right. Carbonic from carbonate group, CO3. Negative 2. So we must exchange valences. CO3, we write 2 here, then we write 1 here, then we can write the chemical formula of carbonic acid. So we write H2CO3. H2CO3. This is the chemical formula of carbonic acid. So we follow the three steps that we talk about in the previous lesson or in the previous session. The first step is to write the positive split on the left. The next step or the second step, we must write the valences above each split. The positive split, write the positive charge and valency of it. And the negative split, we must write the valency above this atomic group. So number two, valency must be written. Then we must exchange valences. Two of the carbonic group, write it under the proton or H positive. And the valency of the hydrogen one, write it under the carbonate group one. So the chemical formula of carbonic acid is H2CO3. Phosphoric acid. Acid, so we must write H positive on the left. Then we write the phosphate group. Phosphate group mean PO4 negative 3. Then exchange valences. We must write the scissor and write 3 here. Then write 1 here. So we can write the chemical formula of the phosphoric acid. H takes the 3. So we write H3 and BO4 take 1. So don't write 1 but write BO4 only. So the chemical formula of phosphoric acid is H3PO4. How to write the chemical formula of hydrochloric acid? Acid, so we must write H positive, the proton, single proton. And hydrochloric mean that the acid attached with chlorine group. So we write Cl negative. Then exchange valences 1 and 1. So abbreviate them with each other. So the chemical formula is HCl. The chemical formula of hydrochloric acid is HCl. Nitric acid. Nitric acid, so acid, we must write H positive on the left. So nitrate group NO3 negative. Then exchange valences 1, 1. Exchange valences. So we write HNO3. We write HNO3. It is the chemical formula of nitric acid. Now we will talk about acids. Acids may be rich in oxygen such as HNO3 nitric acid, or poor in oxygen such as HNO2 nitrous acid. So the NO3 group nitrate group is called nitrate group. This nitrate group when attached with H positive or proton it called nitric acid. So the term 8 converted into the term ick. يبقى from 8 to ick. Nitrate group to nitric acid. Or this acid contain NO2. NO2 group called nitrite. This nitrite converted into nitrous when attached with proton or H positive. So it called nitrous. So we convert the term it to us. Nitrous. From nitrite to nitrous acid. So the classification of inorganic compounds, we must know that the inorganic compounds classified into four types. The first type is acid. The second type is alkali. The third type is salt. The fourth type is oxides. So inorganic compounds classified into acid, alkalis, salts, oxides. Acids compounds ionized in water giving proton or H positive ion. يبقى all the compound ionized in water giving H positive ion called proton. Any compound contain H positive or 2H positive or 3H positive called acid. So any compound contain proton called acids. These acids with pungent taste. And it converts the litmus paper from blue to red. It converts the litmus paper to red color. Such as HCl. HCl when it dissociates into H positive plus Cl negative. And HNO3 dissociated into H positive plus NO3 negative. H2SO4 dissociated into or ionized into H positive plus HSO4. So any acid can ionized in water. If this acid is strong or weak. Such as HCl. HCl when ionized in water it gives H positive plus Cl negative. And HNO3 when ionized in water it converts into H positive proton, single proton plus NO3 negative nitrate group. But H2SO4 may be dissociated or ionized into H positive plus HSO4 negative. Maybe give one proton or two protons. When it give one proton, HSO4 negative release. When it gives two protons, so SO4 negative 2 released. But in H3PO4, maybe when ionized in water give one proton or two protons or three protons. The first proton when it give one proton or single proton H2PO4 negative released. When it gives 2H positive, 2H positive, 2H positive. So H still and remain with BO4 group. This HBO4 takes the charge negative 2. So HBO4 negative 2. When it gives 3 protons, BO4 negative 3 phosphate group released. Acids classified according to acid basicity number. So it may be single basicity or double in basicity or triple in basicity depend on the proton that released. When single proton released such as in HCl hydrochloric acid or nitric acid HNO3, or it give two protons, maybe give H positive one proton or single proton, or give two protons to H positive, such as in H2SO4 sulfuric acid or carbonic acid. H positive, 2H positive, 3H positive, such as in H3BO4, so it called triple basicity. So it depend on proton that released when ionized in water. When one proton, so it called single basicity. Two proton, it called double basicity. Three protons, so it called triple basicity. Ionization classified also into or according to ionization power. So it may be strongly ionized in water or weakly ionized in water. And the acids may be classified into atom attached with hydrogen, into oxygenic acids or halogenic acids. Let me know what is this types, what these types, oxygenic acids or halogenic acids. According to ionization power in water, it classified into strongly ionized or weakly ionized. When it strongly ionized, so it completely ionized in water. This acid completely ionized in water, such as HCl completely ionized in water to give single proton plus chloride group. HI give also single proton plus iodine negative or iodide ion. HBr give H positive or proton, single proton plus bromide ion. And HNO3 nitric acid, when it ionized in water, it completely ionized to one proton or single proton with NO3 nitrate group. HClO4 perchloric acid ionized in water give H positive plus ClO4 negative. H2SO4 dissociated into H positive plus HSO4 negative. Or it can give two protons plus SO4 negative 2. And it may be weakly ionized or not completely ionized. Not completely ionized means that it is reversible or easily to pack to form the acid. When HF hydrofluoric acid ionized in water, it give single proton plus fluoride ion, and then this proton with fluoride ion will combine together to give the same acid, hydrofluoric acid. And H3PO4 is a weak acid, as it weakly ionized or not completely ionized in water. So it can give single proton or double proton or triple proton because it is a weak acid or weak electrolyte. Weak electrolyte. H2CO3 also is a weak acid, and when it ionized in water, it not completely ionized to give single proton or double proton plus bicarbonate group or plus carbonate group. When we classified acid according to atom attached with hydrogen, it may be classified into oxygenic acids or halogenic acids. Oxygenic acid means this acid contain oxygen, but halogenic acid mean that it acid not contain oxygen. When acid contain oxygen such as nitric acid, phosphoric acid, carbonic acid, sulfuric acid, the power of oxygenic acid depend on the number of oxygen atoms that not related to hydrogen. So we can calculate the number of oxygen atoms that not related to the hydrogen with the relation of hydroxylic formula. With this formula we can calculate the number of oxygen atoms that not related to hydrogen. So hydroxylic formula M O N O H all by M. So the oxygenic acid or number of oxygen not related to the hydrogen atom is N. When we calculate N, we know the number of oxygen atoms that not related to hydrogen. So when we have an acid such as sulfuric acid H2SO4, we can see that this acid can wrote or written with the hydroxylic formula. So M write it S, the sulfur element. And the oxygen contain two oxygen OH or pi 2. So It is a strong acid. And this HClO4 called perchloric acid. Perchloric acid contains 3 oxygen atom. When it write it in the hydroxylic formula, it contains 3 oxygen. This 3 oxygen means that this acid is very strong acid. But HSO4 strong acid. And the halogenic acids not contain oxygen, such as hydrofluoric acid. Hydrofluoric acid is a weak acid that weakly ionized in water, means that it not completely ionized in water, such as hydrochloric acid. And hydrobromic acid and hydroiodic acid. These acids are strong acids, hydrochloric acid or hydrobromic acid or hydroiodic acid. Now we talk about the second type of inorganic compounds called alkalis. Alkalis are compounds that dissociate in water, giving OH ion hydroxide group. It gives a hydroxide group with astringent taste or bitter taste. The red litmus paper turn to the blue. Litmus paper turn to blue, combine with acids forming salt plus water. So this alkali dissociates to give Na positive sodium positive ion to plus OH negative hydroxide group. The same way that the KOH dissociated into K positive OH negative and calcium hydroxide, calcium positive 2 hydroxide negative 1. So we write it with this chemical formula CaOH all by 2 to give calcium positive 2 plus OH negative, then balance the equation with 2 before hydroxide group. Alkalis classified according to the ionization power, such as strong alkalis or weak alkalis. Strong alkalis completely ionized in water, but weak alkalis that not completely ionized in water. Sodium hydroxide completely ionized in water to give Na positive plus OH negative. And potassium hydroxide also give K positive plus OH negative, completely ionized in water. But the weak alkali such as NH3 ammonium hydroxide or ammonia solution plus water give NH4OH ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium hydroxide called also ammonia solution. When we have ammonia, we can dissolve it in water to dissociate it into or to give ammonium hydroxide. So this ammonium hydroxide is a weak alkali. compounds ionized in water giving positive ions except H positive and negative ions except OH negative. So salt such as NaCl don't contain H positive and don't contain OH negative. So it is formed from alkali and acids, but it not contain H or OH. Don't contain H positive or OH negative, but contain any ion, any another ion, such as sodium ion, chloride ion. So, not contain H positive and do not contain OH negative. So, it called salt. NaCl, salt. KClO4, salt. KNO3, salt. K positive, NO3 negative. هنا, K positive, ClO4 negative. The result of alkalis and acids reactions. So the salt is formed from alkali plus acid. Let we understand this. So KOH contain OH group or AH hydroxide, OH hydroxide group. When it contain hydroxide group, it called alkali. And when it contain H positive, it called acid. And when this alkali with this acid combine together or react together, it form salt. Salt is formed from K positive ion with the negative ion here, NO3 nitrate group. So K positive, NO3 negative, it called salt. Salt plus water mean this anion or NO3 negative, it called acid. And K positive, it called alkali. So any salt consists of cation, any salt consists of cation or anion. Cation positive and anion negative. Alkali with acid. This cation formed from alkali and this anion formed from acid. And when we react this alkali with this acid, it form the salt, and this salt consists of cation and anion. The fourth type is oxides. Oxides is the result of combination between elements and oxygen. Oxides has four types. The first type is acidic oxides. The second type is basic oxide. The third type is amphoteric oxides. The fourth type is neutral oxides. Number one, acidic oxides, such as SO3 sulfur trioxide or carbon dioxide CO2 or nitrogen dioxide or phosphorus pentoxide. So this acidic oxide formed from sulfur, carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus. We notice that these elements, all these elements are non-metal. So the acidic oxides consists of non-metal oxides, because it consists of non-metals such as sulfur, carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus. So when we found a non-metal and we need to know the oxide type, we must know that this non-metal form acidic oxides. So compounds, these compounds, all these compounds dissolve in water, form oxygenic acid. When we take this SO3 sulfur trioxide plus water, it gives H2SO4 sulfuric acid. Compounds react with alkali, form salt plus water. So these acidic oxides, SO3 sulfur trioxide plus NaOH sodium hydroxide, it gives Na2SO4 plus water. Salt plus water. The second type of oxides, basic oxides. Basic oxides consists of metal, so it must be contain metal, or it must contain metal such as sodium, magnesium, calcium. So sodium, magnesium, calcium, all these elements considered as metals as it contain less than 4 electrons in the outermost energy level. These elements when attached with oxygen form basic oxides. Basic oxides may dissolve in water, form alkali. So such as Na2O sodium oxide plus H2O form NaOH, form basic oxides. These basic oxides when dissolve in water, it form alkali NaOH alkali. Basic oxides may not dissolve in water, form base. So these basic oxides may not dissolve in water, forming base. And the basic oxides react with acids, forming salt plus water. When the basic oxide react with acid such as HCl, Na takes the Cl in the product, so it gives salt plus water. Water H2O plus NaCl. Amphoteric oxides. Amphoteric oxides such as ZnO, zinc oxide, or tin oxide, or aluminum oxide, or antimony oxide. The amphoteric oxides react with acids as alkalis, so it called basic oxide. Or this amphoteric oxide react with alkalis as acids, so it called acidic oxide. So it may be basic oxide or it may be acidic oxide, depend on it react with acids as alkali and react with alkali as acid, and in both forming salt plus water. The fourth type of oxides is neutral oxides such as carbon monoxide. Neutral oxides don't react with alkali and don't react with acids. chemical equations. We study all the previous sessions to know how to write chemical equations. So we know how to write the chemical equation and how to write the chemical formula inside this chemical equation. The chemical equations describes the changes occur during chemical reaction. What is the changes that occurs during chemical reaction? We know that molecules may be compounds and may be elements. When the molecule is compounds, so its formula is X positive, Y negative, such as calcium chloride, calcium Ca positive 2, chloride negative 1. So when we exchange valences, we can obtain CaCl2 is the chemical formula of calcium chloride compound. Aluminium oxide Al2O3 X and Y combined together to form compound Al positive 3 OO negative 2. These molecules may be elements, and these elements may be X and may be X2. X, so the molecule consists of one atom, such as calcium, sodium, magnesium, ferric or iron, aluminium. So these elements may be consists of one atom, and may be molecules that consists of two atoms. The molecules that contain two atoms, such as the three gases and the four halogens. The three gases, H2N2O2, and halogens F2Cl2PR2I2. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen. These three gases and these four halogens found in the form of X2 molecule consists of two atoms. Steps of writing chemical equations. Number one, we must write reactants on the left and the product on the right, and between them we write the arrow in the direction of products. Reaction conditions must be written above this arrow. Maybe heat, or maybe pressure, or maybe catalyst. Number two, write the physical state of reactants and products. We must write the physical state. This physical state, such as solid S, liquid L, vapor V, aqueous AQ, gas G. Balancing the chemical equation, write the balance number in the left of compounds. Number of reactants atoms equal number of product atoms. So we must balance the chemical equation, because we must write an equation in the correct form. So reactants atoms must be equal the product atoms. and this called law of conservation of mass. Law of conservation of mass. How to convert the verbal equation into symbolic equation? When we have this verbal equation, magnesium plus oxygen by heat, it gives magnesium oxide. How to convert it into symbolic equation? Mg plus O2 by heat give MgO. Presence of fraction not preferred in the equation. We not preferred to write half in the equation. So we multiply it in with 2. We can multiply this equation. Multiply by 2, so it give 2mg plus O2 give 2mgO, and we write the physical state under each molecule. If you have solid plus gas, it begin to balance. We must begin to balance the gas firstly. We must balance O2 firstly because it is the gas in the equation with metal. Second example, when we have a verbal equation like aluminium plus oxygen give by heat aluminium oxide. So we must convert it into symbolic equation. We write aluminium plus oxygen give by heat aluminium oxide. So if we have 2 in the reactants and 3 in the product, such as oxygen, here oxygen 2 but here oxygen 3. So to balance this equation, we must multiply 2 multiply 3 and 3 multiply 2. And if we have in the reactant 2 and the product we have 5, so we must multiply this 2 multiply 5 and 5 multiply 2. So we multiply it with 3 and we multiply this compound with 2. And then we must balance aluminium finally. So aluminium 2 multiply 2 equal 4. The chemical reactions consists of reactants and product. The reactants is to breaking bonds, but the product forming bonds. So breaking bonds between reactants molecules and forming new bonds between products molecule. So this definition for chemical reaction. So the chemical reaction is to break bonds between reactants and forming new bonds between products. Types of chemical reactions. First type is direct combination reaction. The direct combination reaction, such as A element A plus B senses AB forming one new material. But the displacement reaction AB plus C, so single replacement. C replace the B to form A C plus B. And the second type of displacement reaction is AB plus CD. So B take the C forming BC new compound and A take D to form AD new compound, another new compound. Number three, oxidation reduction reaction called when we take red from reduction and ox from oxidation, we found that it takes the name redox reaction. Redox reaction. When A lose electron, it called oxidation process. And when P gain electrons, it called reduction process. So product give product A as a positive ion and product B as a negative ion. Number four, thermal decomposition reaction. The thermal decomposition reaction such as AB. Note that this thermal decomposition reaction is opposite the direct combination reaction. The direct combination reaction between A and B form AB. But the thermal decomposition reaction means that AB converted into A plus B. So decomposition process takes place. So AB decomposed into A plus B. The first reaction, direct combination reaction. Direct combination reaction, the molecule A plus molecule B forming new bonds between them forming AB. So only one new material formed. One material only is formed. So when Mg plus O2 react together under heat, so it gives one new material, MgO. And when NO plus O2 react together with heat, it form NO2. NH3 ammonia plus HCl form NH4Cl. NH4Cl. So ammonium chloride formed from the reaction between ammonia with diluted HCl. So there are three types of a direct combination reaction. The first is element plus element. The second is element plus compound. Element plus compound. And the third type is compound plus compound. Number two, displacement or replacement reaction may be single or double. Single replacement, that C replace B, but C must be most reactive metal than B. And how we can know that C is most reactive than B? From the chemical activity series. The chemical activity series contain elements above hydrogen, and all elements above hydrogen most reactive than the elements below the hydrogen. So the most reactive elements ريبليس the least reactive elements such as hydrogen of water replaced by most reactive metal such as sodium plus water forming NaOH plus H2. So sodium replace hydrogen and form sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas evolved and hydrogen of the acid replaced by the most reactive metal such as magnesium and the hydrogen of diol HCl replaced by aluminium because aluminium or aluminum is most reactive than hydrogen of the acid. The least reactive metal such as Cu replaced by Zn, zinc, because zinc most reactive than copper. And the double replacement reaction contain three types. The first type, when alkali react with acid, it forms salt plus water, such as NaOH plus HCl acid, it form NaCl plus water. Acid plus salt, it depend on the type of each of them. So, Na2CO3 as a salt plus HCl as acid. Sodium replace the hydrogen because sodium is more reactive than hydrogen. So it form NaCl plus H2CO3 and H2CO3 weak acid or weak electrolyte. Ionization or ionized in water, not completely ionized in water, so it gives CO2 plus H2O. Salt solution plus salt solution such as NaCl plus AgNO3. Ag replaced by Na and Na take NO3, so NaNO3 plus Ag takes the Cl. The oxidation reduction reaction, the redox reaction. Oxidation and reduction. Oxidation, loss of electrons occurs when the atom lose electrons, so it called oxidation. When the positive charge increased, so it called oxidation. Oxidation number increased in the oxidation. So when the oxidation number increased, it called oxidation. When the positive charge appear, it called oxidation. When loss of electrons occurs, it called oxidation. Reduction mean gain electrons and take the negative charge. Oxidation number decreased in reduction. Oxidation numbers maybe known or unknown. Maybe known or unknown. The known oxidation numbers such as oxidation numbers of 1A, 2A, 3A elements in its compounds. 1A contain positive 1 oxidation number. 2A contain positive 2 oxidation number and 3A contain positive 3 oxidation number. Lithium, magnesium, aluminium. 1A contain lithium, sodium, potassium. 2A contain magnesium, beryllium, calcium. 3A contain aluminium. Oxidation number of oxygen in most states negative 2 except peroxide, peroxide H2O2, Na2O2, superoxide KO2. So in peroxide the oxidation number negative 1 and in superoxide the oxidation number negative half. We will continue in the next session. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel to reach to a large number of students. And thank you for watching. Bye bye. See you again.